Well, good morning, dear parishioners and friends, and welcome to our weekly segment of Coffee with Monsignor Jerry. I hope you have your favorite coffee mug. One might look like this or something similar. And your favorite beverage, and you're going to your special place so that you can be with us virtually for our presentation. So let's have a good day and everybody enjoy our beverages. This week we're celebrating the 19th week in Ordinary Time, and I'm sure you remember about this past week's gospel. Jesus is walking on water. You might remember that he has fed 5,000 and more people. They've had enough and even more. Now Jesus is going away and the disciples are out in their boat. A wind comes up. They're all afraid. Jesus is walking across the water and he says to them, "Do not be afraid." Matthew 14:27. "Don't be afraid. It is I." What happens? Peter says, "If it is really you, Lord, and not a ghost, I want to walk on water too." Starts walking on the water, and then he realizes what he's doing, and his faith goes away, and he starts sinking. Jesus' response, "Wow, what little faith you have." So we want to ask the Lord to give us strong faith, faith that would lift us up, like it would have lifted up Peter from the walking on the water instead of sinking. So we want to again proclaim that we're not going to fear because our future belongs to God. God has the plan and it's always going to lead to good. So we're going to do that. And today I would like to do some more words of encouragement from the scripture about do not be afraid in this time of COVID. But if you want to keep reading ahead in Matthew's gospel, next week we're going to hear from him again, and as we will through Ordinary Time. So just stay ahead. Keep be prepared for the readings that are coming along. So we know, again, that there's a lot of anxiety, a lot of fear, a lot of doubt in our world today. We're not quite sure about how to handle all the stuff that's coming to us. The reports are varying and different. But let's examine some more words of encouragement in the Bible. So today I'd ask you to consider these quotes. The first one would be Deuteronomy 31:6. Now, in this part of the gospel, it's a part of the Old Testament, Moses is 120 years old, and he's talking to Joshua, and he says, "I'm going to die pretty soon. You're going to take over and lead the chosen people into the chosen land." But he says to him, "Be strong and be courageous. Do not be afraid. Don't be terrified, for the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you or forsake you." Now, would that be really encouraging for us today? The Lord is with us. The Lord will never leave us or forsake us. The more we believe that, the more we trust in God, the better and calmer our hearts will be and our faith will be strong. Then, in Joshua 1:9, the divine promise of assistance is given to Joshua. And Joshua leads the chosen people. They go to the promised land. And the Lord says, "I command you to be strong and steadfast. Do not fear or be dismayed, for the Lord God is with you wherever you go." And also in Joshua, in verses 8:1, 10:8, 10:25, and 11:6, are these same words. Do not be afraid. The Lord is going to guide you. The Lord will be with you. So it was so prevalent in that book of Joshua that the message was, you have a lot of challenges. You have a lot of things to be concerned about. But the Lord will be with you. Good words for us today, right? We have sort of the same situation. Lots of stuff going on, confusion, anxiety, sometimes even despair. We don't have to. All we need to do is take these words of the Holy Scripture, allow them to touch our hearts. Then in Psalm 23:4, now we're pretty familiar with Psalm 23, aren't we? The Lord is my shepherd. Verse 4 says, "Even though I walk in the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff comfort me." Those are really consoling words from the psalm for us. Wherever we go, whatever, as dark as it might seem, the Lord will be with us. He'll be our strength. Then also in Psalm 27:1, "The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom should I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life, whom should I be afraid?" Other consoling words. All we have to do is ask God to help us have the strength to believe it. And then finally for today, Psalm 29:11. Probably noticed already that the Psalms have tremendous hopefulness in them. The Psalms lead us into faith. The Psalms lead us into no fear. So Psalm 29, verse 11, the Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace. And that's certainly a wonderful message for us today, isn't it? The Lord is with us. He's giving us strength. He's going to bless his people with peace. So keeping that in mind, let's ask for God's blessing and bow your heads for this blessing. Gracious and loving Father, we are trusting in you. Sometimes our trust is failing, so we ask you to bless everyone, make our trust, our faith, and our hope in you constant and strong. And we ask your blessing upon all God's people. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, dear friends, for joining us in this segment today. May you have a blessed week, and see you next week.